The Quran wasn't in one book in the time of Prophet Muhammad. It was on something like sheets here and there, and it was memorized in the hearts of the companions. And then after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, what did he do? He gathered the sheets and he compiled one book that he called Al-Mushaf Sharif. The word Al-Mushaf Sharif about the Quran didn't exist in the time of Prophet Muhammad. Who called the Quran Al-Mushaf? Abu Bakr, when he compiled all the Quran in one book. And then, on top of all that, are you with me? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his time, the Quran was written like without any kind of fatha, dhamma, kasra, dhammatayn, kasratayn, fathatayn, or sukun. It was written just like drawing the letters without any kind of points above or under. No points in the Quran, no dots, nothing like that. On the ya, on the noon, on the ta, no dots. In the time of Abu Bakr, no dots. In the time of Umar, no dots. In the time of Uthman, no dots. In the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, they innovated this good innovation by putting the dots in the Quran. This is a bid'ah. Why the dots in the Quran is a good bid'ah and al-mawlid, it's not a good bid'ah, it's personal. So we say, listen good, in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no mi'zana, no minarets in the mosques. There were no minaret, there were no mihrab in the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then, in the time of Abu Bakr, mihrab or no mihrab? No mihrab, no mi'zana. No minaret, no mihrab. You know the mihrab. In the time of Umar, no mi'zana, no mihrab. In the time of Uthman, no mi'zana, no mihrab. In the time of Ali, no mi'zana, no mihrab. In the time of Al-Hasan, no mi'zana, no mihrab. In the time of Muawiyah, no mi'zana, no mihrab. And after that, until Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, in the year 99 or 100 of the Hijrah. 100 years after the Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz was the first to build what? The minarets and the mihrab. So this is a bid'ah also. So this is a bid'ah, and the dots on the Quran are bid'ah, and the mawlid are bid'ah. Why the first two are good and the last one is not good? There's something personal against the Prophet. The minarets, until now, those who go against mawlid, they build it. Until now, those who go against mawlid, they make mihrab in their new mosques. So this is a bid'ah, but it is a good bid'ah. On top of all that, did Abu Bakr ever heard a CD, for example, for a qari about the Quran? The CD itself that has Quran in it is a bid'ah. But is it a good bid'ah or a bad bid'ah? It is a good bid'ah. In the time of Prophet Muhammad, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Al-Hasan, or any other Khalifa, did the calendar exist? The times of the prayer, did it exist? It didn't exist. 300 years ago, it existed. So this is a bid'ah. But it is a good bid'ah, and they print the calendars on which there is the time of the prayer. Why the calendars are a good bid'ah and the mawlid is a bad bid'ah? There's something personal against the Prophet, so be careful. How to be careful? By learning and strengthening ourselves in the teachings of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Nasarahum Allah. The teachings of Abu Hanifa, Malik, Al-Shafi'i, and Ibn Hanbal radiallahu ta'ala anhum wa ardahum. So, in summary, the bid'ah is divided into two, a good bid'ah and a bad bid'ah. And the mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is among the good bid'ah in Islam. So this is why you're doing something good. Ba'den, on top of all that, Allah said, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ in the Quran. It means do the good deeds. Let's see, to gather the people to make salat ala al-Nabi, good or bad? Good. Type, bringing the people together from all nationalities, different languages, different colors, in one place, loving one man under the banner of one religion, which is Islam. This is good or bad? This is good. Type, bringing the people and giving them free food. This is good or bad? Good. Giving them good drinks, free drinks. This is good or bad? Ya khayya, where's the haram? What you don't like about al-mawlid? they don't like that you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They go against the Mawlid. When they hear the word of Mawlid, they freak out, wal'iyadhu billahi ta'ala. As for us, our life, we live our life loving Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We teach our kids to increase their love toward the Prophet Muhammad. We teach our kids to love the Prophet Muhammad more than they love us like parents, and more than they love life itself. Nare takbir. Nare risala. Nare risala. Ya Rasulallah, nare risala.